Hello friends, welcome to freepush.com, and this is my new project, Hospital Management System. Normally, I have given the title that Medicare, because I have developed this project for a student and the title was Next Medicare, that's why. But you can change the title according to your need, that you can make it Hospital Management System, or you can make it Hospital Appointment System, or anything what you need. Okay, that is only the text, that is not an image. So you can change it easily from the file. Okay, so let's start with the technology stack. So I have developed this project in PHP and MySQL, and I have used the PHP version 7 and MySQL version 5.6. And for front-end development, I have used the Bootstrap theme. So the main advantage of this project and the main functionality of this project is I have integrated two of the Bootstrap theme in this project. The first is for the front-end panel and the second is for the admin panel. And there are four types of user in this project, four types, okay. And the first type is the patient, the second type is the doctor, the third part is the hospital, and the fourth part is the admin. So admin is the super user, hospital is the user below the admin, the doctor is the below the third level of user, and the patient is the minimal functionality user. Okay, and each and every user has their own dashboards, right? So this is the main feature of this project. So for front-end part, I have used the Bootstrap theme. Two of the Bootstrap theme, the front-end is also the Bootstrap and the back-end is also a Bootstrap. Okay, and both themes are totally different. And I have used jQuery libraries. I have used the some of the jQuery plugins and the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So this is all about the technology stack of the project. So let's start with the project functionality go through. So this is the home page of the project. You can see this is really a very nice home page, and you can change the image, you can change the text from the from the quotes directly. Okay, so this is the about us page, and you can change the text here also from the code. And this is the doctors. So this is the totally dynamic page, and the content of this page is coming from the database directly. So if you add more doctors, then that doctor will come here also. So this is the doctor page, and this is the contact us page. You can see this contact us page is really very awesome, because the pop-up is showing the map as well as the contact details. So you can change the contact details here. So this is the user login page. So there are, as I have told earlier, there are four types of login here in the page: the doctor login, patient login, admin login, and the hospital login. So then I will go through one by one. Okay. And this is the sign up page, from where a doctor can sign up and a patient can sign up. Okay. So let's start with the functionality go through of the login page. So this is the doctor login, and this is the pop-up. And if you enter the doctor details, let's go with the patient login first. So this is the patient login, and I am logging as a patient, and this is the patient dashboard. You can see if I log in with the doctor dashboard, then the dashboard will be different. But in the case of patient, the dashboard will be different. So this is the my account section, from where patient will go on this section directly from here also. Right, so this is the book appointment. So if I want to book an appointment, then what I will do, that I will choose the doctor from the drop down, and the date and the time slot and the fees. What I am paying is 1000 for now. And this is the contact number and address and description. Suffer from cold. And once I click on the book appointment, then it's asking for the credit card details. So don't worry, this is a very this is not a real payment gateway. This is a sample payment gateway, and none of the real transaction will be done. So what's my name is Kaushal, and this one is the credit card number, and this and the expired, and fees what I am going to pay is the 1000 rupees, and the make payment. So once I make the payment, then I will get the payment details, and the currently the status is pending, but it will be confirmed only by the admin, right? So this is the appointment things. So where patient can book the appointments from the doctor, and this is the book appointment, and then the appointment history. So this is the appointment history. which I have made in past. So if I click on the view appointment, then I will be able to see the appointment details here, right? And this is the test history. So this is the test history, all of the test history which had been done by the patient. So patient can see his test history, and if he clicks on the view details, then all the details will come here. And after that, this is the medicine purchase, then what the medicine the patient has purchased from the hospital, then all the details are here. Then, and also admin can see the detail, sorry, the patient can see the details of the medicine here also. So this is the doctor prescription. So on the each and every visit, patient get the prescriptions. Then this is the prescriptions details. And once patient clicks on the prescriptions, then patient will be able to see the prescription details. So this is all about the patient. So what the patient can do? Patient can book the appointment and make the payment. Patient can check the appointment history. Patient can check the test history and details, medicine history and details, and doctor prescriptions. So this is all about the patient, and this is the logout functionality. Now I am going with the doctor details. So this is the doctor login, and so this is the dashboard has been changed, because I have already told you this is the four types of user login, and this is the second dashboard. And what the doctor can see? Doctor can see the my account section, where doctor can be able to update his detail. And once he clicks on the my appointments, then doctor will be able to see all of the appointment details. And once he click on the view, then what the doctor can do? Doctor can add the prescription for this patient. Doctor can see the prescriptions history of that patient. Doctor can see the view test histories and medicine history. So in add prescriptions, the appointment ID is 2 and the date. And if I anything add it here, then it will be saved in the database, right? So I am going on the my appointment section and view section, then view prescriptions history, then this is all about the prescriptions history. And after that, the test history, and also I am will be able to see the prescription details here, right? And again, this is the test history. So this is the test history details. And again, this is the view medicine history. Then this is the view medicine history details. So what the doctor can do? Doctor can see his all appointments. Doctor can add the prescriptions for that appointment. Doctor can see the prescriptions history, test histories, and medicine history, as well as the details of each and every section. So this is all about the doctor section, which I have developed in this project. Again, I am going to log in as a hospital. Then there is a hospital login. So this is the hospital login, and you can see this is the second bootstrap thing which I was talking about earlier. And I am logging with the admin. Sorry, hospital. So this is the hospital and test. So this is the hospital dashboard. Then what the hospital can do? Hospital can see the doctor's management screens. Also from here, hospital can add the appointments, and hospital can see the appointment details, right? And you can see this is the appointment details, and this is the add doctor details, from where the hospital can add the doctors, add his only doctors, right? If hospital A is adding the doctor, then hospital B will not be able to see the doctor. So this is the main advantage of this project. Okay, so this is the doctor details, and you can see the details of the doctor, which can be edited by the hospital. And this is the logout section. This is the all about the hospital section. Now I am going on the admin panel. So this is the super admin. So this is the admin login, and I'm logging as admin. And this is really a very, very, very big section of this project. And what the admin can do? Admin can appointment management, time slot management, doctor fees management, doctor schedule management, test management, patient test management, patient medicine management, prescriptions management, patient management, and the user management, the log reports and logout. This all functionality will be done by the admin. So admin can add the appointment for any of the patients. Admin can see the appointment reports of any of the patient. Also, admin can delete the sorry, I think delete the delete any of the appointments. Doctor admin can add the time slots. Admin can see the time slot reports. Admin can add the fees of the doctor. Also see the fees report. And this is the edit screen. And admin can add the schedules of the doctors. And this is the schedule report. So this is all about the schedule. The admin can add the tests. That what type of tests are there. Admin can see the test reports. Right, these are the test reports and the test durations. If you can see, this is the details. And patient test. Patient test means what the test has been taken by the patient. Then this is the patient test details and the patient test reports. This is the patient medicine. So where admin can add the medicine for the patients and the medicine report. This is the prescriptions. So all the prescriptions has been taken by the admin, the patients, and this is the prescriptions details. And if you click on this, then you will be see the details of the patient. Admin can add the patient. So this is the patient add form. Admin can see the patient reports, right? Also admin can edit and update the details of the patient. And this is all of the reports. So this is the appointment reports. This is the time slot reports. This is the fees reports. This is the, so this all our reports are here. And this is the finance section, appointment payments. So how many payments has been done? And this is the fees payments. Then what are the fees? And then medicine payments. So these all are the medicine payments. And this is the user. So admin can add doctors, any number of doctors. And then this is the user reports. So these are the doctor reports. And then my account section and the logout. So this is all about the admins. And as you can see that there are four types of admin login. And sure, this is, I am not saying this is a very big project, but sure, if you need more functionality in this, then I will implement it. Okay. And if you need to enhance this project, and if you want to learn from this project, then you can get the source code. You can buy the source code from the link below the video. And don't forget to subscribe our channel freeposition.com for getting the latest video updates on the latest position technologies. Thanks for watching the video. Thank you very much.